painting this commission, so I just want to show how do I make a sort of the Chinese shading technique. It's not complete like 100%, but because usually this shading technique is used for rice paper on rice paper or a pre-prepared like with a special glue. Silk, not like a raw silk like we are using the like I'm using today. Like most of silk panel using today, we're using the raw silk. We don't really prepare prepare it with any glue or anything. So anyway, so this is a raw silk. Let's have a look what to do. I'm just gonna leave it like this, and okay. So I have a flat painted. My flat paint means there's no just one color and on most of the leaf. Now I'm going to use some black. Okay, let's get to the camera a bit higher. Like that, maybe. Okay. I will have some black. So this is the commission I'm painting. Is this one? Okay, so now I have finished the outline, finished the edge. I'm just going to do the rest of it. I am mixing the shading color, and I will use one just a thinner. So this one's pure black. I'm not gonna use a pure black. So I will use two pen brush. A smaller one for the darker color and the bigger one for lighter color, the smaller one for the darker color. And this one I'm going to use just use thinner, so there will be no color on this one. So There's two ways we can do it. I usually do the middle first, and then wash the duck, wash it out. Dark one, usually in the middle. And I will use another one just for the green. Usually the dark color it's on the middle, along the middle of the leaf and the bottom of the leaf. On the tip are usually lighter. So just wash the joint where they join together, just wash it. You can just repeating this until you're happy with the shade. Nobody says how many times, there's no limit because I usually do 2 or 3 times. So now I'm not focused on which color I'm going to use, if it's green enough or not. I'm just focused on building the shade, and when it's dry, I will check which adding green on it. But now I'm just concentrate on the how do you call that? Transforming from the dark to the light. And I'm shading the leaf which is covered like on the bottom in the shade, and I'll just make it very dark. And I leave this part, the green, some of the green is like the back, like when the leaf flip, the back of the leaf. So maybe have a close look at this one. So I have three pen brush here, but this is a dark one. This is no color. This is a light green, the green as I used for here. First find out which one is the in behind. In the shade. So wash the edge, like where the black and light, just make them even as possible. In Chinese, when we paint on rice paper, we do it from dark to light. Because it's dry very fast, so the quicker you can shading it, the more natural it will look. This one is a bit dry. I'm using the concentrate black and English blue for the dark color. It's a bit difficult to find out which is behind, which is in front. This one is really dark because it's really at the back. Don't even need to shade it. This technique is very common in Chinese painting. It's very much like pencil drawing for Chinese people, for Chinese artists. So, which one is at the back? Maybe this? So you can see like it's in the middle of the leaf, the end of the leaf, which very close to the stem are the darkest, and then it radiates out as it's further become the center, that it become lighter. Well, same for the flowers. The center of the flower are the darkest. So this one I'm not coloring it because this one represents the back of this leaf. So, but here, oh, it should be a bit darker. That to build the depth in this leaf. And see, this one's not very even, so I'm gonna go over it. Sometimes it can be nice when it's not. We want that texture, but for this picture, I don't want the texture. So I'll make it as smooth as possible. So, where's this one? Okay, this look like this one. This one look like it's at the back. So I'm gonna do that. The new leaf have a slightly warmer green. So this one look like the back or the front. I'm not sure really. Well, that's just think I missed this. I want to put this one back. Okay, I'll come back to that one, and here I want it to go with the background, so I'm gonna close that. You know, if you miss some gouda after you the gouda when it's wet, don't paint straight away because the color will make the gouda really dirty, and then it won't be able to pretend it going to the other side. I don't know if that makes sense. When I'm painting, my brain doesn't work. So I'm not gonna paint here because or this area because this too is wet. So I'm gonna go here instead. You don't have to use black, and you can use dark red. To or any darker color. Just in Chinese painting, we usually use the black to make the draft, not the draft, the underpaint. We use black and wash it, wash the shade to make the underpaint, and that way flat paint the top of the color, which I will do some flat painting after the shade is made, finished. So, what's this? Okay, so here is not dry. So I'm not approaching it with very wet paintbrush. I just use a little bit. Okay. What's that? I really like it. I don't remember which part is which. Just go with the guess. Okay, I want to leave that one. And leave this one. This flower here is quite dark. The shade, oops, I get it dirty. It's not the end of the day, but I'm going to wash that. The best way is to dilute that dot to the rest. And this bit looks dirty now, but then once we steam that and wash, it will wash off. So this flower is red, but now I'm just building the shade. So I put the black in there just for the shade. Once I cover this with red later, the black will become the black part. The shading part will become darker red. Which one here? This one look like on the top, so I do this one instead. If we color every, if we color all of them, we don't leave any lighter one, it will just look weird. We need to have some lighter one, like SD card. Let it play what the bright leaf light catcher. So this one is look like. Behind. Okay. It's behind the flower. So this bit is definitely behind the flower, so I'm gonna make it dark behind the flower here and here. And this one look like from the back. If the it okay, now it's definitely at the back. Seems like that's all of my leave. Okay. Got one more. One more here. When it's close to the flower, I mean, the flower is on top. So shade it. Shading. Now this part is dry. I'm going to put some I'm going to color, make the color brighter. My battery is really low. I don't know how long it will last, but I will paint as long as the battery still. Before the battery die. Okay, now I'm gonna have some dark blue. I'm using which blue? This one is very warm. So I'm not gonna use this one. I use this. 612. This is a H DuPont I'm using. But I'm not only use that, I will add some dark black on it. So I use my dark pen. This flat paint. And the clean one. Wash on top of that, the first shade to have this blue green. So this one's getting really dark. Same for the here. Now I'm using the same paintbrush to the dark and the lighter. Still wash it with a clean paintbrush. So after two layer of washing up, washing, shading, the shade, the color should look quite rich. So more darker and wash. When it's very dark, the golden really shine through it. Okay, my screen is really dark now. I'm gonna stop the video here, and if I get charged later, I maybe come back when I'm doing the flowers. Thank you for watching. Good.